Yeah, you put the white man above the Asian woman.
I feel oppressed right now.
You stay down.
Yeah, you're just, you know, you don't have to say anything, sweetheart. You just stay there.
Nerderotic.com.
From deal frenzy to decoupling, is the China Hollywood romance officially over? 5 years after an unprecedented era of frenzied East-West deal making, cash flow has stopped. Donald Trump's trade war lingers, censorship is on the rise, and human rights abuses in the Middle Kingdom have upended business prospects for the U.S. film industry. It's hard to know what's going to happen. Yeah, well, apparently it's not for Disney to do business with a company that happily thanks a concentration camp.
Don't trust China. China is asshole.
In the run-up to Chloe Zhao's historic Best Director win for Nomadland, I haven't seen the movie. I heard it's visually stunning.
It's not a well-made movie. It's just not exciting. It's that typical Oscar film where it's boring for the vast majority of movie watchers, but I personally thought it was a solid film.
Was it a Best Picture?
Based on the options they had this year, that's the other problem, is that they have fallen into this trap of nominating very specific types of movies where, you know, especially during a year like we've had where there haven't been a lot of movies and a lot of films have been pushed back and have been delayed. They stick their nose up at films like The Gentlemen, for instance, by Guy Ritchie last year, which I believe was the best film of last year.
With regard to China, the director's home country and the studio's most important international market, an executive for Disney-owned Searchlight emailed members of the Hollywood press on March 4th. You may accurately refer to her as Chinese or a Chinese national. A number of news outlets, including the New York Times, had mistakenly referred to Zhao as an Asian American. Disney had abundant reason to be concerned over how the provenance and perceived allegations of its rising star director, who was also helming the studio's forthcoming $200 million. They did not put $200 million into the Eternals.
That would not surprise me.
How? I mean, did they buy a lot of green screen fabric or something?
I mean, when you think about how much a film typically costs in the MCU, that sounds about right. Between $125 and $200 million. I mean, actually, that's not even on the higher end of what an MCU film would typically cost.
We have no idea what this movie is going to be about. Like, I have no idea what kind of like effects they're going to have in it. We assume it's going to be a shit ton.
Wonder Woman 84. Yeah, I understand it. Eternals?
I have no idea.
Okay, so the Eternals, now it's a $400 million movie with the marketing, all the delays. It's almost a $500 million movie. This thing's going to flop hard.
To me, the big test is going to be Black Widow. If they don't make money domestically and in other countries other than China, then yeah, I would not be surprised if they push more films back if they don't do well with that film. And also, for a frame of reference, Guardians of the Galaxy, so kind of a similar, where it was an unknown to a lot of people property, similar to the Eternals. So yeah. Guardians cost around $170 million back in 2014 for budget. It's pretty comparable when you adjust for inflation, things like that. Yeah.
There you go. For months, the studio has been making clandestine efforts to avoid agitating the Chinese Communist Party when it came to Zhao, who was born and raised in Beijing, but attended high school in London and Los Angeles, college in Massachusetts and New York. The simple fact that she now lives in Ojai, California, was certain to irk the CCP and provoke China's notorious internet ultra-nationalist, whose MO is to aggressively scrutinize any Chinese artist who achieves significant success in the West, searching for hints of disloyalty to the motherland. Wow. This is great that we're just completely catering to.
China is asshole.
Sources say that in late 2020, a Searchlight publicist persuaded the small New York-based filmmaker magazine to remove a quote from a 2013 Zhao profile in which the budding auteur explained the inspiration for her first feature film, Songs My Brother Taught Me, about a Native American teenager looking for escape from the tough conditions of South Dakota's Pine Ridge Indian Reservation. It goes back to when I was a teenager in China, being in a place where there are lies everywhere. You felt like you were never going to be able to get out. A lot of info I received when I was younger was not true, and I became very rebellious towards my family and my background. I went to England suddenly and relearned my history. Wow.
Again, 10 years ago, this quote from the interview came out, and that's what they are hung up on.
You know what's so creepy about this is that what she's saying here is something that I've been hearing a lot of people lately say, people who have either immigrated themselves here at a young age from a communist country or who have family members who escaped a communist country. They are awake to all the propaganda and the noise that we see happening in our culture currently because they've been through it. They've seen it or they've had family that's seen it.
Like Carrie said, people are waking up to this stuff every day. And God, this might be what it's like to work at Disney right now. It's probably very similar. Lies everywhere. You don't know who to trust.
Yes. See, what she's describing is what a lot of Americans might read this at this moment, depending on where they work and how much they have to censor themselves. They might read this and go, hey, wait a minute. That sounds familiar. Like, is that what I'm going through?
Sounds like my job. But it turns out the studio's efforts were for naught. While the quote has been removed, archival versions were unearthed in China shortly after Chow's Best Director win at the Golden Globe, setting off a social media backlash that prompted Chinese authorities to cancel the local release of Nomadland in April and expunge most mentions of Zhao from the internet. The controversy reached its zenith, with the Oscars being fully censored in China. Her achievement nearly doesn't exist to 1.4 billion people living within China's internet firewall. The prospect of an Eternals release in China is murky. The CCTV 6 China movie channel recently aired the U.S. release date for numbers of upcoming films, but omitted the Eternals as well as Marvel's Shang-Chi. Now Disney is like, oh shit, China's always going to alter the deal. Dumbasses.
I feel like whenever they try so hard to appease China, it goes really poorly for them anyway. Marvel movies typically do pretty damn well over in China, like Thor Ragnarok. The numbers for Thor Ragnarok, pretty damn good in China. I don't think they really did too much to try to appease that audience or appeal or pander to the Chinese audience. It just did well. I don't really like that movie, but that's besides the point. Just make good movies and everything else will sort itself out. I think that's the bottom line, both here and in China. But instead, they do this. They try to bend the knee. They try to appease them, and it never works.
When you look at a lot of these companies, you know, they can talk a big talk about wokeness and diversity and inclusion, and we care about marginalized people and all this propaganda that they try and suffocate us with here in the States. But when it comes time to put your money where your mouth is, or to actually, what does your behavior say about you? They don't give a crap. This is fake. It's for show. It's all for show. They're only going to do something if they think enough people are paying attention. Lately, I'm kind of looking at it as like people who are full of crap and people who are tired of that.
Yep.
You want authenticity and want your words to mean something. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk.
No. I like how Carrie says crap. I like it.
If you like what I do here, please consider subscribing to the channel and liking and sharing the videos. It really does help. And if you did this with your favorite YouTuber as well, I'm sure they would appreciate it as much as I do.